Hello everyone, welcome back. I am Arpit Modi and this section is going to be very interesting. So let me show you the dashboard that I have prepared. Okay, this shows the car module and car sales, car revenue, city wise breakup, in which state how many cars were sold, then number of complaints against that car, what is the fuel tank, what is the capacity of their car, what is the power, what is the value of the car, what is the top speed, mileage, everything you can see in this one dashboard. So let me check Elite i20, which is of 5 lakh rupees in INR. These are the specifications, these are the complaints, number of highest complaints were against engine, highest sales were in Delhi, and this is the car sales, month on month car sales. Swift again, see, everything you can see for a car to get the output. So highest number of complaints were on gearbox or accelerator brake, clutch related. So what I did making this, you need not to have Excel Pro, but you need to have the ability to read the data. Let's say I have this raw data ready with me. What I'll be doing, I'll be using all the concepts that I have in my videos, earlier videos. Okay, so this is the pivot table that I have prepared. I am converting them into the charts and multiple axes. See, changing the chart type, then I'll be converting into the secondary axes, deleting the data, adding my favorite chart layout. Okay, so this is what I have currently, month on month number of cars versus revenue. I am using all the techniques and connecting dots from my previous videos. I am not doing anything new, though I have downloaded some pictures from the Google, but I am just adding them to represent in a different format or different way. So this is the pie chart for number of cars per city. Okay, again I have represented, or I have explained, or we had seen this pie chart in earlier videos of a pivot table, if you remember, or if not, go and understand how we had made this video. So one chart, two charts are ready, another chart is for complaints. So let's see what I'll be doing for the complaints. I'm putting complaint type, number of complaints over here, and complaint type of complaints in the row label. Done. These are my complaints. So this is the bar chart I have, or we have rather, for these complaints. Number of type of complaint types, I would rather type. Deleting, I am just removing this field data. Done. So now let me change the layout of all the chart types. If you can see, I'm just changing the colors of the chart. Okay, this is black, done, black and black. Okay, I have changed the format, not the values. I am making it very appealing, though black color is appealing, yeah, we can understand, but I have prepared these three types. Now let's say I already have this three of the, what I can say, Three of the pictures downloaded, already downloaded from the Google. Okay, so average unit price that I am putting, top speed that I am putting, values, everything will be in row label. This is what I am doing just to simplify my work going forward. See, this is in INR, Indian rupees. So these are the average price, top speed, mileage, BHP, everything. So what I need G5 and KMPH top speed. Okay, so what I'll do, rounding up to one digit or zero digit for that matter. So this is one more formula, AND formula, concatenate, that you want to do if. Okay, fuel tank, average, BHP, mileage, KMPH, fuel capacity, BHP, everything. I am just making the raw format right now. And going forward, I'll be representing this data into the actual format. Okay. So this is the bar chart I have. See. This is horizontal bar. I'll be changing the width of this bar. I have first changed the color, now format data series. Rather, I'll be changing the width. See, I have changed the width. Done. So my chart is ready. Now I have to have KMPH chart. For that, I'll be using the rotational chart first. So just a minute. Yeah, so mileage, this is the vertical bar, the earlier was the horizontal bar. Average of PHP, done, delete. Okay, probably I have the higher amount of PHP. Format data series, no gap, done. This is the raw format that I am making. I need raw format I am making, and after that I'll be putting in the representing manner. See, this is the fuel tank capacity. Okay, making the axis the definite, that is 60 liters, that should be the highest. Deleting all the axes and raw data labels, I'm changing the format data series, so with no gap, done. Fuel tank is ready, BHP chart is ready, my car price chart is ready, month on month car versus revenue ready, complaint chart is ready, number of cars per CT pie chart is ready. So after that, I'm just making this layout so it will be more appealing. See, I'm getting these charts into the place. Month on month car versus revenue trend is here. All you need to have here is connecting the dots. from my previous videos. I am just connecting the dots, nothing else. See, all the charts, formats were ready. Explanation is ready. You can see in my another slide, 1, 2, 3 things are ready. Now I am copying this picture to here. Okay, why did I do this? I have this image downloaded from Google with the car background, car shaped, transparent. See, I am putting it into transparent mode. So this is how your car shape will appear. I am embedding over the car shape. Not more of technical thing to do, but you need to have this imagination before translating any data into this format. So now horse shape will come here. This is PHP. You can see here I'm getting this data into horse shape format. Okay, then my horse is ready to move, my BHPs are ready to move. So I have aligned these horses. Then see, my another chart is ready. Now I'll be having fuel tank chart. Fuel tank chart will also be ready after putting this already prepared fuel tank chart, or rather you can say layout will always be ready. See, done. All you need to have this imagination how you want to represent data. Okay, so equal to the value of this cell, fuel tank capacity. Now I'll be copy and pasting this chart, deleting the data. So I want BHP over here, so equal to value of this cell, so AK7 BHP. Done. Now I want this meter, speedometer chart. We will be going, sorry, let me have this first. Average price. Okay, so this is the price of the car represented differently. Done. So we will be creating this speedometer chart. For that, what I need is the maximum speed, which is 160 km/h, and I'll be restricting it to 250 maximum speed. Okay, so this is where I am going to create this chart, converting into donut chart. So I'm just changing the layouts. Done. So how many number of you need 250 different columns or different segments. Okay, speedometer will have the gap of 250, so range would be this. Okay, so we have donut chart. Change chart type. I'm converting into pi. Format data series, secondary axis. Format data series, I'll also be converting into secondary axis. Done. Changing the layout type, I'll be making this transparent. Okay, changing the chart type to donut. See, so easy. This this is how I create, or we anyone can create this speedometer. Combination of two chart, you need to have the maximum speed, minimum, and the speed at which you want to go. So that will show the speedometer. Plus, you will have to have the cap at which you want to show the speedometer. I'll be having, or in this chart you will see 24 different lines coming together. So 24 sections. Each speed is having at 10 kmph. Each section is representing 10 kmph. Accordingly, going with that criteria, we are having top speed of 160 kmph for this part. Now, also we learned about the slicers. So I have to add two slicers, make and model. In this sheet, sheet number 3, we need to have criteria for all this pivot tables, and we have to connect them. So I have connected all the pivot tables, changing the color of the slicer, make, body, done. So this is how you can analyze, or anyone can analyze the model. Okay, so let's start Creta. Creta has a different cars I am showing over here. Creta 165 top speed, 15 kmph mileage. Wagon-R has 120 top speed, 20 kmph mileage, 35 liter fuel tank, so and so forth. 5 lakhs rupees. City wise breakup, that number of cars were sold, month on month cars were sold. Different cars in different layout will appear. For example, Alto at 47 bhp, while CRZ 88 bhp. So you can see horsepower is coming up and down, going up and down as per your requirement. So basically I have downloaded all the pictures earlier and converted them into the format in which I wanted. So yes, please do subscribe Random Timeline on YouTube. Reach me on modiarpit48@gmail.com. Let's have fun together. In next video, I'll be explaining about the dashboard, that how to prepare the dashboard with all kind of formulas and conditional formatting and stuff. So thank you very much. Do subscribe to Random Timeline on YouTube. Have a good Excel ahead. Bye-bye.